hopeless man who gives hope to other people. It just helped me to express what I have been thinking all my life. Isne mujhe touch kiya hai. I'm going to give my heart to this. And let's see what happens. Pressure's there. But it doesn't guide me. A lot of my father's friends told my dad, what is your son doing? You should not do these this film. He's a big star. Hi guys, this is Hrithik Roshan and you are watching Bollywood Hangama.
All right, so finally we have with us Hrithik Roshan. He's having a terrific run right now. Super 30 has been doing exceptional business at the box office. But more importantly, it is bringing a change. People are talking about it, why it's important to incorporate education as a very, very important aspect of everyday life in the country. So pleasure having you back on Bollywood Hangama.
Thank you.
And we always genuinely hope that you do far more, many more movies because we are meeting you after 2.5 years. We genuinely hope that.
Yeah.
All right, and how do you feel? A movie which is doing exceptional business at the box office, at the same time, it is becoming a talking point. People are talking about the relevance of such coachings, why it's important to pursue higher education, and how it can possibly affect the future of the country.
It's very important. Without information, education, that all is your ammunition that you need to navigate your life. Without knowing about the world around you, without knowing about the social happenings around your city, your country, your world, it is very, very hard to navigate yourself. So that's very, very important. But that's not why I did the film. I did the film simply because it was a damn good script. It impacted me at a cellular level. It filled me up with so much passion and it impacted me so much that I just knew that I had to do this film. And I think the reason is because it talks about a hopeless man who gives hope to other people. A man who has seen such hopelessness decides to give hope to others who have been hopeless. And he tells them to dream. He tells them, yeah, you don't worry. So it's telling our children to dream. It's telling our kids, our children, and all the people who are finding themselves in a hopeless environment to dream. Dream the impossible. Why not? You dream. And at the same time, it is inspiring the people who can help those people to make their dreams come true. So it's inspiring the contributors, the people who can build those roads, those platforms to help those people to make their dreams come true. So it is actually triggering a spark at both ends of the spectrum. And this this loop is what causes progress, growth, evolution. Because if the dreamers and the people who need to hope and dream don't hope and dream, you will never move forward. And if the people who can help those people don't help them, then it's again an uphill task. So it is doing something that's so magical. It is doing that at a macro and a micro level. Because even inside you, there is a side of you that is sometimes hopeless. And there is a side of you that sometimes is in a position to help someone, to contribute. So it's inspiring both those aspects within yourself also. That if I'm hopeless, I should not be. I should still hope. I should still dream. And if there is something that I can do to help this person or that person, yeah, what can I do? What can I do to contribute to people, society, world? What can I do? And if you ask these questions, you will get a lot of answers. So it's doing that, and that's what it did to me, which is why I fell in love with it.
You personally found it inspiring as well.
Oh my God, yeah.
And got cathartic in a way.
It was already
when you said it gave you hope, and
it is already something that it just helped me to express what I have been thinking all my life, most of my life. I wanted to say these things. I didn't know how, and then the script came along, which is why I gave my life to it. I was like, wow, this is something that I really, really believe in.
So when the script came to you for the first time, what was your initial reaction like when you just read it for the first time?
Oh, I was blown away. I was blown away. By the end of the film, at the end, I was shaking. I was crying. I was shaking. I was like, I was just taking these deep breaths and saying, I can't get over it. My God. It's such a triumph, this triumph of spirit, this film. I'm a sucker for these films. I'm a sucker for triumph of spirit kind of films. So yeah, it really, really impacted. I was blown.
So anyone who has followed your trajectory?
And there were people who told me, don't do such a film. You know, but they told me the same thing before I did films like Koi Mil Gaya. That you have an action hero image. What are you doing? What kind of films are you doing? It's very important to fight the mathematics and calculation when it comes to things of the heart.
Right.
You know, films and creativity should be done from the heart. And that's how I would like to do it. Of course, you can't judge others, but I really feel that creativity and things of the heart, you should not have thoughts about box office, business, manipulations, calculations, permutation, combination, all out the window. Isne mujhe touch kiya hai. I'm going to give my heart to this and let's see what happens.
You're saying that box office maybe is something not a part of the consideration, but the fact is that you're one of the superstars of the country. For the last 15 years, you've consistently delivered big blockbusters. So I think box office pressure to a certain extent must be there.
Yeah, pressure is there. But it doesn't guide me. It doesn't steer my decisions of not doing a film that I know is good. So like when Zoya came to me for ZNMD, it was again a thought that, you know, a lot of my father's friends told my dad, what is your son doing? You should not do these this film. He's a big star. If being in a status where you can empower good scripts is what being a star means.
It's all about.
If you ask me, if being a star means ke dukaan khol ke baith jao aur abhi to just keep earning, keep shelling out films that work, and keep you know, money rolling. That for me is not being a star. I think anybody who has a status where they can empower good things, people, scripts, whatever. That is what you should use your power for. And sometimes it will work, sometimes it will not work.
Right.
But that doesn't mean you should change your way of life. Hi guys, this is Hrithik Roshan and you are watching Bollywood Hangama.